Usual story for you now. Men may soon be able to prevent pregnancy with a flip of a switch. A German inventor named Clemens Bimek suggests surgically implanting his switch, giving men the choice of being fertile or not fertile. Dr. Ilan Tsimkis from the Fertility Partnership joins us to talk a little bit about this invention. And he was just sharing with me that this guy's a carpenter.
Yeah, he's maybe even
an electrician. He came up with this. They say that perhaps this could make in the future vasectomies obsolete. Tell us how it works.
Well, he designed it, has a patent since the year 2000, and he got a surgeon to implant it in him in Germany and prove that it works.
So is he the only one?
He's the only one who's had it done, but the reason why there's the news buzz is that he's been approved to now put it in 25 people in Germany and 25 men and prove its effectiveness and all the things that we have to check before this becomes public.
It's a surgical procedure. It's literally a switch that's underneath the skin.
What happens, it's in near the scrotum where the testicles are, and you need two because there are vas deferens tubes that bring sperm from the testicles to the outside world.
So two switches.
There's actually two switches.
What if you flip the wrong switch?
Now, you know, the truth is that switches exist for similar things. There's something called a penile implant. For men who have issues with erection, you can press a button and the penis can swell and turn the switch off. So that's not new.
All right.
But the idea is that this switch will be turned, you could press the button, and then the surgery actually you have to cut the vas deferens and put both ends into this. It's like a switch, like an electrical switch or a plumbing valve. So it would go on and off. It won't work immediately.
Well, the issue with vasectomies is sometimes they're not reversible.
Right, exactly.
Well, whereas this gives you an option either way.
You would turn the switch on, and you would still have to wait probably at least a month or more before all the sperm on the other side of the switch had cleared. So it's not going to be.
So how do you know? You go to your urologist and check it out, or
I'm not sure how simple this is going to really be.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure how soon it would be available in this country, but I'm sure this is going to undergo a lot of testing because, like you said, you may want the switch in, and what happens if you want it out, and then the complications of surgery and pain.
Any talk of pain?
We only have one person we know that's had it put
and
in.
And he invented it, and obviously he wants to market this thing, so he's not saying. What about infection?
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
So we don't know.
Well, they're using materials that are proven to be safe in human bodies. There's a special polymer.
Not something in his carpenter shop.
Exactly, yeah. Right. Well, I mean, the exciting thing is that the search for male contraception goes on.
Yeah.
The burden of contraception has primarily been on women, and there's so many things happening. There's a new gel that could be squirted in that would last up to a year that is being developed in California, and that's past animal testing. We think that's on the horizon. There's recently, last month, there was a study that showed we figured out how sperm actually enter the egg, the sort of whipping of the tail,
yeah.
And that's driven by progesterone. So they're talking about maybe there's a pill that could be taken to inactivate that. So there's a lot of interest and giving some of the burden onto men.
Yeah.
And this is
I heard a lot of that. I heard a lot of that in the newsroom. So, doctor, thank you so much for coming.
My pleasure.
Keep us posted on that. You're going to be watching the updates on these 25 people who will be receiving this carpenter's invention in Germany.
Exactly.
Sounds like science fiction. Let's go over to Lisa.
Thank you.